All right, geologists. So we'll start off with a few more vocabulary words. It really needs to be a much easier word for vocabulary than vocabulary. Seismology, okay? So that's where we're moving into for the next two lessons. Seismology is the study of earthquakes and all of the stuff related to that. So all of the phenomena related to that. Next is we have basically one of the tools that a seismologist, that's the scientist who studies seismology, would use, and that's a seismograph or seismometer. Now, seismo, earthquake, graph, meaning to, you know, graphic, make a graph, or meter, to measure it. You know, that's what it does. So it's an instrument that measures features of earthquakes. So it's anyone, really. So whether it's force, duration, etc. It will, simply, the ones we look at work like this. You have a needle, either a needle or a pen, and a rolling tube of paper. And that paper just rolls constantly, and it just constantly draws a line like this. And then any tremors, in other words, earthquake, happen, and it's like that. And then you'll have the aftershock, and it's like, and then you'll have a bigger aftershock, and it's like, whoa, check it out. And that's how a seismometer works. All right, next one. All right. So, as we know already, earthquakes happen due to a release in energy. So you have the two plates pushing together, and they're like, and then boom, and they snap apart. And when they snap apart, that releases energy, and that's what causes our earthquake. So the focus is the point where the earthquake begins. Now, down there, that little spot there, that's the focus. Now, it may be close to the surface, it might just be up here, maybe, you know, 60 kilometers down, but it might even be 200 kilometers down, you know, as far as that. So where the two plates are going under each other in a subduction zone, if you've got there can be a release of energy down where the bottom crust is actually melting into the asthenosphere. So, yeah, like they can happen quite deep down. Obviously, the closer to the surface, it's not obvious and it's not necessarily true, so I wouldn't say that. So there's the point where it actually happens, where the release occurs. Then you've got the epicenter, and that's the spot right above the focus, like directly above it, on the surface of the earth, and that's where most of your damage is going to happen. Alright, so that's where we start, and then the next lesson we're going to talk, it's a bit more intense, and we're going to talk about some waves. And yeah, alright, top work.